got Steve Vickers going at someone. There's a third man in situation. It's Dornhopper. And Ross Lansbury, I'm sure, will be ejected from the game as a third man in. Now Ron Harris is over there getting a hold of Dornhopper. Now Ashby separates him. Now Joe Watson is getting at him with Dale Roth, who towers over him by a good head. And Ranger fans now feel that they've got this game in the bag, 5-3 with 5:57 left. Why not add a little icing to the cake with some intimidation and some battle? Flyers appeared to shake the Rangers, leading after the midway point of the game 3-1, but then Vickers, Hatfield, Park, and Gilbert, two of them on the power play, have broken it open and given the Rangers a two-goal lead. Now we're going to have some more penalties, I'm sure, and it probably will be Vickers and Dornhopper, and then perhaps Lansbury on the third minute. 5:57 left in the third period, 5-3 Rangers. Madison Square Garden, we had the first all-out go. As Lansbury has left, and he will be the third man in. So the Flyers lose Dornhopper for at least five, or pretty much the remainder of the game, and Lansbury for the remainder of the game. So it means that they've lost two-thirds of their big line for whatever challenge they can make in this final 6 minutes against the Rangers, who have a two-goal lead. Well, if the Rangers win this one, Don, it assures game five back at the Spectrum next Tuesday evening. And we want to repeat game four here Sunday afternoon at 2 o'clock with WPEN AM and FM carrying the pregame show beginning at 1:55. Vickers and Dornhopper will each get 5 minutes for fighting. And Lansbury, the third man in on the game misconduct. 14:03, the time of the penalties. So, strategically, those penalties hurt because they, pretty well denuded the Rick McLeish of his normal wing players on this last rush down. Well, now they